though this is a very humble and really a first effort to try to empower the American community and make sure our voice is heard, it has profound impact. I'll leave you two stories from my community in the state of Missouri. So I'm recently the executive director of CARE here in Texas, in Dallas-Fort Worth. And what's happened is when I was in Missouri, we did Capitol Day and lobby days. And of course, every year that state legislator introduced the anti-Sharia legislation to basically, you know, ban Sharia or whatever that meant to them at the time. SubhanAllah, because of Capitol Day, we were able to defeat that legislation four times in a row. And each time it got progressively closer to passing. So one time we were able to defeat it because we actually got the governor to veto it, and we got a Republican member of the House to actually vote against it when they try to overthrow the governor's veto. Believe it or not, during one of our Capitol days, the person who introduced the anti-Sharia legislation, again, this is the guy who introduced the anti-Sharia legislation, he's the one that also went and made a video that said Muslims are trying to take over America and we have to quote unquote stop the Islamization of America. So for you and I, we might be like, this guy is kind of cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs, there's no point to even meet him. Believe it or not, myself and a small group of people, we met that person, and after our meeting, we changed the idea of anti-Sharia legislation to this bill is gonna make our community unsafe and make us a target of hate. And because he was a big, like, law and order type of legislator, he, that day, at the after our meeting, the same day, he the one that took away that bill. So the guy who introduced the bill after meeting us took that bill away. And again, we had no votes, no numbers, no money, nothing, but we were able to convince that person. These are humble efforts that can make a big, big change. Alhamdulillah, Missouri is one of the few states in the whole country, and especially in the Midwest, that's a Republican-majority state, that has not passed anti-Sharia legislation. That's same with anti-BDS legislation. So in Texas, unfortunately, anti-Sharia and anti-BDS legislation that passed, of course, they've been challenged in court. But in Missouri, both of those bills did not pass until, of course, the anti-BDS bill passed just this last year. Why? Because we met with officials one-on-one, we explained our concern, and just by getting a few of them to vote against it, we were able to stop it from happening. So there are success stories. Your voice does make a difference. Do not undersell yourself. You can make a difference, inshallah.